Hey guys and girls, what's going on? Welcome back to a brand new series, Jurassic Park Season 2. Much better now, guys, with Oceancraft, you know, shaders on, as you can see. If you guys want to know what this is, I'm going to show you right now. Go into Options, Shaders. This is the Zipzaps Shaders V2, so it's the Chocobit 13 shader. So make sure to go and get it. I would thoroughly also recommend the Zeus one. I'm not using it purely because my computer isn't actually good enough to contain it, to be honest. But for now, it's okay with this one. Now, if it does turn out that it's not brilliant, which I'm okay with it at the minute, I think I will change it and it will look a lot nicer, just normal, it'll be more effective for the video. But for now, I think we're okay. I think we're all right for now. So what we'll do is very quickly get on with building everything. So we'll get the crafting table on the go and we'll very abruptly go and take one more block of wood out. That's great, we'll take all the wood all out of here. Nice and easy. Now, the main part of this series is quite similar to last time, but just to improve it, really. It's just to make it a lot more better, a lot more efficient, a lot nicer, and that's what we're going to go with. So, at the minute I need, well, the only thing I need at the minute is a pickaxe. A wooden pickaxe, and I just need to nip over here. Now, if you guys want to know what the seed is, if I just do slash seed, there's the seed, guys. Make sure to pause it here if you guys want to download the seed. It's a nice seed, to be fair. I do rather like it. I mean, there's a lot of grasslands by little areas of water like this, so it will be nice for the exhibits. Now, with this series, I really want to benefit the dinosaurs, to be honest. I want to benefit what it'd be like actually for them, because recently I've just thought, oh, it's a dinosaur, plonk in an exhibit, it'd be fine. It wasn't like that though, was it? Back in prehistoric times, it was a lot different, and I want to basically recreate their habitats within the enclosure so that they actually feel, you know, quite happy, they're quite content. A bit like the Prehistoric Park series, we're trying to replicate what their habitat would be like just back then. So that's what we're going to be doing. Quite simple, nothing too, you know, difficult. It's just we're pretty much collecting wood though. But for this episode, we are obviously purely looking at, you know, just sustaining ourselves in this world. I've put it on peaceful just this episode, just until I, you know, get a bit of food, like from the chickens, and until I get like a little farm going. So it might be until like episode 3, but I promise you, after episode 3, it will go on to easy, and it'll be all good from there. Now then, if we just quickly go and take this tree. Quickly just go take this tree out, we should be okay. Now if you guys have any questions that you want to let me know, or if you guys can recommend for me the first dinosaur you guys want to see, let me know it and I'll see what I can do. There we go, is that everything from that tree? I think it is. Oh wait, now drop down. We need as much wood as we can get at this stage. I don't know if this actually looks nice or not, because it feels a bit laggy. It generally feels a bit laggy, which is quite annoying. So what I'm going to do after I've just taken this tree down, so I'm going to take the shader off, and we're just going to have to go with that, because I'm afraid it's not looking too good. But that's fine. So what we're going to quickly do is Options, Shaders. Turn it off. If you guys want to use that one, let me know. But there we go. That feels a lot nicer. So much nicer. But yeah, that's what we're going to be doing this episode, pretty much collecting a load of wood, turning into whatever we can and gaining whatever we can at this stage. Now that was a big tree we just took down. Like, there are lots of saplings here to take, which is awesome. We can set ourselves up a little tree farm. I think we left one somewhere. I just got it? Yeah, I've got it. Right, so I'm going to mainly aim for the oak trees for now. But obviously that can change. But yeah, guys, make sure to let me know the first dinosaur you guys want to see. Preferably not one of the massive dinosaurs like a T-Rex at this stage. Something simple. Hopefully I'll be able to get it. I mean, obviously it's going to be a bit difficult because I'm going to have to go away and do a bit of mining. Now, there will be some episodes I've decided I'm going to be doing a lot of work off camera to, like, finish off exhibits or improve exhibits, which I'll show you. But I will also be doing, you know, occasionally, like, say, once every 10 episodes, we will have a mining trip. We'll basically just go on a mining trip, see what we can get, come back, analyze it all. I'll probably skip a few parts and just show you guys the highlights of what we actually collect. But it's just so you guys are aware. So, if we just quickly take this tree down, I think we're ready to get started. but I don't know if we have enough wood. Anyway, we're gonna build the house. Do I have enough room here? I don't know. I want to build it on a bit of a point that's quite open. Not too open that we can't, like, open enough, but not too open that we can actually put an exhibit on it. So maybe here will do. Yeah, here will be nice, actually. Let's just get rid of the dirt. I'll probably best use just normal dirt blocks. Yeah, so if we get rid of the dirt here, that'll be nice, because then we can build an exhibit. We can build, like, a little house here, and then you have loads of exhibits around us. Now, I've already thought of a few. I mean, let me show you around here. Around here, there's a little dip, so that's a possibility. As you can see here, we've got like a little bit of a decline of dip, so I might make that a, like there, turn that into a beach, turn those two layers into a beach, and these two, a bit of a pool, yeah, a bit of water for the Henodus exhibit. Then here in this little bit that's been, almost looks as though it's been like caved out and through, I could actually put my house here if I really wanted to. Do I? No, I don't really. But yeah. Pretty much here, I might stick the visitor center, or we can have, you know, an extra exhibit going there. I'm not too sure. That's just things for the future, guys. This is why I quite like this seed, because it's relatively open and allows a lot of progress. So if we make a start, I don't really know where to start though. So we're going to say the front of the house is going to be, the front of the house is going to face that way. I'm going to say, yeah. Yeah, we'll say that. So what we'll do is we'll come out to here, and I want to go up with normal oak wood logs. Is that high enough? I don't know, but we'll stick one out there. Then I want to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Basically just to the end, apart from one block out. So if we just go this in line, yep. 2, 3, 4. There we go, quickly just like that. Yeah, that'd be fine actually. Let's have a, just a little look at that. Yeah, that'd be nice to start with. And then from there, we'll carry on. I need one coming out here though, don't I? And we'll go backwards like so. To probably, where does it keep going? Where does it extend? It extends here, so we'll have to go one in from the extension. And then we'll go across this way, like so. And then if we go one more actually, that'd be nice. Oops. Yeah, that'd be good. So yeah, the general idea is just build pretty much planks at this stage. Just to put down a bit of a base from where we're going to go with. We'll go like that. And just come up with like a general idea of what's actually going to go down. So if we've got one coming across here though, we need to go to this side and place one there. And eventually somebody will come through this bit here. So we'll have one bit coming out. Yeah, so that's good. So what we'll do is go and collect a bit more. Now I'm pretty much just setting up pillars because I want my pillars to be actually visible within the production. Now I think this house will be very nice. But yeah, it's going to be pretty much, it's going to be a really nice series. I'm really happy about it just already. I mean, I've already got the majority of the series actually planned out. Some of the episodes are going to be literally just let me know what you want to see, and I'm going to bring that in an episode. But I'm going to do a lot of research, like an awful lot of research on dinosaurs and their habitats, where they would have lived, what sort of time period, because I've decided to go for where, because we're actually going to create an actual zoo. Last time it was pretty much just put them in a pen and hope for the best. This time we're going to be actually sectioning them off into the either biomes they would have lived in or into the time period they would have lived in, so say Cretaceous, Jurassic, stuff like that. Ones like that are quite nice. I think it'd just be generally quite nice to do. Thank you. Is that everything? I haven't got wood. Why have I just put dirt there? Honestly. There we go, that's nice, yeah. And we need going down there, don't we? Oops, change that. There we go. Beautiful, just like that. I do like that actually, that's really nice. And if we keep coming back out, I'm literally going to take it right round here to that point there and bring it in. Now, we need to get the wood. Whereabouts should we get it from? Because I can't be doing with spruce at this time. I see a big tree up there. And I like the look of it, actually. But no, pretty much, I just want to make all the exhibits. I want to make it a genuine zoo. Like, for example, this series Zoo Tycoon, like, there's that as an actual game itself. I want to relate it something to that, so we'll actually at one stage have like a border going around the zoo. That'll probably be an off-camera thing, I'm gonna say, because that'll probably be nearer to the end once we've got everything built in, so we know what we're doing. But yeah, I'm pretty much gonna be setting down a lot of landmarks. I'm probably gonna try and replicate this world in creative, and then have a little look around at it, see what I can actually find, and see what will look really nice. But yeah, I think this will go really nicely. I'll probably put a few more planks down there, and bring that one across here. But no, overall, I think it's going to work really nicely. I mean, I like the sky. It looks fake over there, but it's not something I'm massively concerned about. I don't think I really need the shader packs. I mean, they're nice, but I'd much rather have a fully functioning world rather than having half bits not rendering and stuff like that, just for your benefit. I mean, I wouldn't mind so much if it was me just playing on my own, but it's the fact that, yeah, you guys do deserve a lot better than that. Come back here, chicken. Oh, some XP fell in there. I may as well kill you then. Come on. Face your fate. There we go. Is that... Oh, that was one there. Beautiful. So yeah, guys, pretty much just going to be building a house today, getting a lot of things sorted and running through things with you guys. Now, a quick question is, do you guys want to see it, like I've just said, based on the biomes they live in or the time period they live in? So say we could have the late Cretaceous period in one corner of the exhibit, we could have the Jurassic period in another one. We could have, there could be absolutely anything, guys. And then we could change it around. We could have... biomes. We could have, say, an ice biome. So we'd have, say, Smilodon, Elasmotherium, Mammoth, all in one sort of part of the park. We could also have a Site B put in. We could have a Safari put in. Honestly, guys, there's so much we can do with this series, and there's so much I can't wait to do. One that's going to be a personal favorite for me will be building a Pteranodon exhibit. I want to make it a bit like a hilly cliff by a seaside, because that was where they were renowned to be found, obviously nesting. So I think that'll be nice when it comes around. When the time comes, I think that'll be a really nice exhibit to do. But for the time being, got to focus on the task at hand. Did that give me nothing? I thought it was going to give me a chicken there. I was about to say, what? So what is going on? Alright, I need the saplings as well. However sad it is to say, I do genuinely need the saplings right now. That's what we need. Oh, damn it, I've run out. Damn. But yeah, pretty much, it's just going to be a nice, leisurely series, getting you guys involved, and something I can really work on and create in my own sort of perspective of how I see things, along with your perspectives. So it should be a really nice series to do. I'm very happy for it, and I'm really excited, really, for the future that's going to come with it. Now, if we just make our way back to the house that I now have no idea how to get to. But yeah, pretty much, it's going to be nice. It's going to be really nice, I reckon. Now, if it just gets out of my way, I can actually get up. Let's just carry on all the way up here. And we'll head out through here and hope for the best. Always the nicest trees. That's a nice little biome, actually. That'll be very effective in the future. But where actually am I? On a serious note, let's set the time to day as well, because that's annoying. There we go. Beautiful. We can actually see what we're doing now. It's out this way and over this hill. But yeah, loads and loads of things to happen. Do I have any? I do. That's good. Two sticks, three cobblestone. Beautiful. So guys, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go away for a minute and collect the rest of the wood, and I'll come back in a minute when we're back at the house. So I'll see you in just a second. Right then, guys, so I am back, and as you can see, I've done a little bit of work. So what I've done is actually gone and doubled the layer and added a bit of a porch to the top roof. Obviously, it wasn't very easy to get up there. I had to use a dirt quite a bit. But no, we got it. We got it sorted. Now, pretty much, I want to do this. Now, I just nipped into creative mode for 1 minute to test out this glass to see what I thought of it. Obviously, I'm going to break it. But I just want to test it out, see what it thinks. I do quite like the borderless paint, so we might have to go and get a few of them at some stage. But yeah, so I'm quite happy with that. I mean, I don't actually know. What did I do with this? I forgot what I did here. Oh yeah, I tested a few things out while I was also off camera. I've decided to go for that sort of approach with the logs. I took all this out at the minute, so we're going to start and dig everything out in a minute and use the birch wood that I went and collected. So yeah, pretty much a lot has happened off camera. I've been doing a lot of testing, seeing how things have gone, and that's how the series is going to be, guys. It's going to be a lot of just that, of purely me just going around testing things, making sure it's all working. But the main idea at the minute is to just build something that looks like this, which I can show you as soon as I've stopped messing up. There we go. So it's going to look like that. It's going to be a 3-2-3 formation, almost like I'm playing FIFA, but not quite as many men. So what we're going to do at this stage is just quite clearly keep going and filling things in. Now what we're also going to do is then replace it with glass. So when we do this, 3-2, oh wait, there's not enough there. Let's go 3-3 there. Or should we go 2-2-2? How's a 2-2-2 look? I know, it'd be a 2-1-2, wouldn't it? Oh, how's that look? Oh, I prefer that, actually. I think I prefer that. So yeah, we'll go with that. And pretty much just going to be straight line, as always, filling in everything around here. Now, this will be actually quite useful for when we do get around to things. Now, I know it's not the best, you know, most appealing thing to look at in this perspective of saving resources. Why do you have to do that to me? But I think it looks very nice, actually. So that's what I'm going to use, and hopefully it should work out quite nicely. So how many is here? Is that the same? That's 2-1-2, isn't it? 2-1-2, right there. Beautiful. Now we need to get the rest of the oak wood. That's fine. And what we'll do very quickly is just clear out all this, because that's going to do my head in. There we go. Like so. Now it's quite basic to do. I don't know if I'm going to do this with the top floor. I think I'm probably going to repeat it on the top floor, to be fair. But again, 2-1. Oh no, this one's a thingy. This is a proper one. So this is a 3-2-3. So yeah, pretty much just going to be filling everything, making sure everything's okay. But I'm not going to worry you guys too much about that. What I'm going to do is actually I'm going to skip ahead. Actually, I don't think we need to. But yeah, we do. I need to skip ahead, and what I'll do is I'll take out all of the dirt here, and I'll replace it with the birch wood. Now, it's actually going to be normal birch wood planks just there, just to make it seem a lot more brighter. I'm also thinking of taking out all the dirt below the actual wood, purely because it doesn't look as, it looks nicer when it'd all be filled in with the actual birch underneath. So I'm going to go away and do that, and I'll be back with you in just a moment. Right then, guys, so once again we are back. I'm going to just show you the house from the outside now and what the work, like what work I've done. Now when I actually looked here, what I'd done is I've realized that was on the top roof, so I replicated it below, and it's actually made quite a nice porch. But basically what I've done is I've filled in all these. I've actually changed the general design of a few of them. I've brought added extra few blocks in, done a few bits. I've added in a doorway. So like when we're walking through to go into different bits, it actually looks like a proper house. I'm not going to put any doors in because I'm going to leave it quite open. I'm just going to put a few glass panes in there. And then if we go around here and make our way upstairs, I'm going to put a little torch in there, I think, just to light the place up a bit. Make our way upstairs, we have outside. I've not actually put the roof in yet. I'm going to do that off camera before next episode, so that'll be good. And then we come out here, and I'm going to put glass going there, across each one of these, going up right to the top, so we can look out and see basically all of the park. So yeah, that is pretty much everything I've done for the house. Now, the last thing we need to do actually is go and get ourselves a little bit of cobblestone from just over here, just so we can make a couple furnaces, and also some sand, which we can smelt in the furnace to make glass, and then we can get finished, place all the glass up. I've actually gone and spawned in a Dinopedia and the chisel, so we can use a chisel mod nicely and effectively, so that should be very nice to use. Hold on, it's 8, isn't it? So we need 2 more. I think, yeah, it is. So if we quickly just go and get some sand from... I'm not actually too sure. Oh, some over here. And that'd be nice actually, because that'll flatten out the land a bit around here. So yeah, so we'll get hopefully some sand. Hopefully we can actually get enough to finish the house. I mean, it doesn't look brilliant from this perspective, so I'm going to work on that off camera and find a way for it to look nice. It should look nice. I think it's just got, I don't know, I feel as though it might have a few too many logs in. I'm not too sure. I will have to look at that. I may even say it looks a bit too square, so I may on the corner there bring it across. I don't know yet. I'll have a little look off camera, see what I can do, and then when we come back in the next episode, it will be 100% sorted. What's that? Oh, just normal stone. I thought that was iron then for a minute. But yeah, so pretty much it's just going to be nicely collecting the rest of the sand and picking it up. Now, how much do we actually have? Just for around 50. That will that be enough? I don't know. It may be. Maybe we can make a start on it. We need some coal as well, so we're actually able to smelt it. We'll do that now. Now, do I even have my axe? No, it broke, didn't it? Damn. So what I need to do is very, very quickly just get this bit sorted. Here, grab the rest of the coal. We'll just take these two out here, and that'll do us. That should be plenty. Kill the chicken, take its XP and food, and then we'll make our way back. Now, I haven't had anything there that added any sort of, you know, window to that part, but it's quite a simple reason, to be honest. It's just I'm making an enchantment table there. So I want to get an enchantment table here, so I've decided I don't need any form of glass on the back, so that should be fine. Now, where is the crafting table? There it is. Now then, we need to make ourselves very quickly a furnace, 2 to be exact, and then we have our 50, okay. So what we're going to do is quickly just nip around here into here, I'm going to say just for the time being, and chuck 2 furnaces there. Split one, split, 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 there we go. And then what we're going to do is carry on having a look. Now quite a lot of this glass will actually turn out to be panes because it fits out, it fits the design a lot better to be honest, because the logs are quite circular with the tree captivators mod, making it look a lot nicer. So yeah, there's lots and lots to do. I can't see any sand apart from like one block here on the mini map. So very quickly, if we just take all this out. Now if you guys have any sort of, you know, questions or ways you can actually improve my house, do let me know. Let me know in the comment section below or over Skype. In the comment section will probably be easier and I'll probably reply a lot faster on there. Make sure to let me know, guys, as all of your comments are much appreciated and it does help the channel grow insane. So let's just get the rest of this sorted. Is that everything? Missed one bit here, didn't I? And then the few blocks there. That is 30, so that should be enough. I think that'd be enough. Let me just split it so as soon as we get in there, we can sort it. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with how this episode's gone. I mean, we've got the house going. I will obviously finish off the rest of it off camera for you so we can actually get straight into the whole building and construction work in the next episode. I think we're going to go on a bit of a mine next episode, I think, just so we can get, you know, a few things set out and basically just prepared, to be honest. So if we just have a quick look, get the glass, we can get some glass panes going on. 16. Now this is what I want to do with the doors. I initially want to put the doors there. Not the doors, so I want to put the glass panes here for the doors. Like such. There. Now, it's not quite the same. It's quite actually a low-down house, I've just realised. Could have raised that up a little bit more, but... yeah, we haven't got it here. Those are still to be added in. I mean, I can add them here if I want to, but... just need to save whatever wood I have at the minute. So I think I'll keep them there for the time being. But we need normal glass to go there, so yeah. What I'm going to do, guys, is finish the rest of the build off camera, and the next time you see this house, it'll be sparkling, new, ready built. I might even, you never know. In this time, I could do absolutely anything with it. But thank you guys very much for watching. Make sure to drop the like on the video if you did enjoy. Subscribe for more content. All of your comments are much appreciated and really help me out, guys. So thank you for everything, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.